According to us, our Jain thinking, that karmas form karmic matter, and you see only its effect through our day-to-day, empirically, how we behave, what are our activities. So this is embedded in the soul, so they are very peculiar particle according to, so the next one. So ye soul and karmic matter, one representation. अपने पास में काफी है, all of us have plenty of them, but Sadhu ji will have lot of less doubts, less karmons than we would have, because of the belief कि जितने कम कार्मिक डेंसिटी हो, second जो है truth, the next one. So there is a soul, it is a theoretical representation. Soul is a rectangle, is a very simplified what is called synthetic way of representing it. And then जो काला dot है वो hormones है, and you want to be keep away from them as much as possible, just like mosquitoes here, you know, जो डिंगू चाहिए या क्या चाहिए, you have to be keep off. So light, we know that is what we are seeing. Light outside is from photons, but we can't see photons, you know, but we know the activities कि light is मतलब होती है, only physics will tell us that it is a composed of photons. Similarly, electricity, जो भी काम में कर रहे हैं, it is formed from electrons, but you can't see. तो अपनी belief ये है कि केवल ज्ञानी को see these hormones. That's our belief. I think that's what
hormones means. Hormones.
Yeah, hormones. Just like photons are particles. So, जो karmic particles, जो physical, you know, material particles are the word karmons. So karmon rhymes with photon, electron, protons, neutron, you can carry on. So it is a karmon is a proper word in the sense, because when you go deeper, then when you come to karmic matter, it has to be composed of some particular elements. So the what it composed is of karmon.
So but as for the Jainism, what is the karmonic meanings? What is the related with Jainism? Matter, karmic matters.
What is it?
Karma.
जो अपने कर्म प्रकृति कहते हैं, इन जो कर्मा है, so that is simplified.
All regular activities.
No, it is more than that. I think we'll go through and then we'll come to, it's a very subtle question you have asked. कि अपन देख नहीं सकते पर ये क्या करते हैं, you know, कहाँ है वो, you know, so this is a one of important question of next, you know, how do you, अच्छा, so this is something which is, because partly it is through analogy. So intrinsic properties of soul and contamination, आप बोल दीजिए भाई. No, I think I would be very much interested in clarification.
No,
sir. नहीं घबराइए मत. You know, if you are looking for a gold, then you get ore. जो कि ore के अंदर कचरा भी होता है. You know, it got a dust. When you do the mining for gold, तो उसमें जो dust होती है, then you remove and then it becomes. So our analogy in all scripture, first analogy is that pure soul is gold, पर जो उसमें dross है, जो कि ये आपने माइनिंग में से निकाला, उसके अंदर सब कचरा है, कचरा इज कार्मिक मैटर. इधर तो अगर प्योर, अगर आपने सोना एकदम सोना देखा हो, तो दिस इज एन एनालॉजी, बिकॉज इट्स अ वेरी डिफिकल्ट कंसेप्ट. बट देन यू कम टू प्रैक्टिस, यू अंडरस्टैंड, क्योंकि इवेंचुअली इफ यू आर गुड देन यू आर गुड. ऑल रिलीजन एट द एंड ऑफ द डे, बट इट गोज डिफरेंटली, बिकॉज इट गोज डिफरेंटली एज यू विल सी. So roughly ये दूसरा क्या है कि next slide बता देना ना, जो भी modern analogy है, तो क्या है कि अगर सोना है, if it is a gold, then it has got all these infinite bliss, infinite knowledge. जो अपने सिद्ध हैं, उसमें अनंत ज्ञान, you know, उसमें ज्ञान की कमी नहीं, जितना चाहिए उतना देख सकते हैं, everything is infinite, infinite bliss, उनको सुख, जो है जो, so these are the like gold, पर क्या है कि they get from karmic matter, they get either obscured, either they get obstructed or defiled, तो ये जो कर्म हैं, कर्म उसको, तो आप लोग कितने लोग जानते हैं कि अपने मूल प्रकृति आठ आठ तरह की होती है मोनी कर्मा जो जानते हैं सो दीज आर रिलेटेड टू अवर स्क्रिप्चर बट दिस हैज बीन पुट इनटू द मॉडर्न कॉन्सेप्ट बी नेक्स्ट करना तो ओके सो ये है जो पहले का ये दीज आर द इनसाइड है वो जब प्रॉपर्टी ऑफ द गोल्ड एज इफ वेयर और ये आउटसाइड है ये दक्षिणावर्णीय आप जो कहते हैं ग्यारहवर्णीय दैट हाउ दे इंटरफेयर इंटरफेयर विद प्योरिटी तो ये दिस इज ये क्लासिकल रिप्रेजेंटेशन है व्हाट आई गेव यू वाज मॉडर्न रिप्रेजेंटेशन ऑफ द सेम थिंग और आपने मंदिरों में देखा होगा किताबों में देखा होगा सो अगर आप मेरे से कोई ज्ञानी हो आई बीन आस्किंग धीरज भाई यू नो मेहता यू नो ही रोट क्वाइट अ लॉट ऑफ बुक्स ऑन कार्मिक थ्योरी यू नो ही ट्रांसलेटेड सो आई आस्क हिम दिस सिंपल क्वेश्चन कि ये कहां से आया है किस यू नो कौन से आगम में इसका कौन सा श्लोक है जिसमें सब है तो वो उनका अच्छा आंसर था ये तो परंपरा से आता है और आपको आगम जाना चाहिए तो अजय सागर जी से पूछिए सो आई एम गोइंग नाउ टू अजय सागर जी सो दीज आर नॉट दीज आर इम्पोर्टेंट फ्रॉम वेस्टर्न एंड दोज वर थिंकर्स उनके लिए ये बहुत इम्पोर्टेंट है कि ये बेसिक चीजें हैं सो जो आपको मैंने एक एनालॉजी दी कि द मन विच इज गोल्ड एंड देन ड्रॉस द ओर उसमें गंदगी उसमें कचरा बट द मॉडर्न एनालॉजी इज सिंपल इफ यू टेक क्रूड ऑयल जो आप उसमें से पेट्रोल बनता है तो क्रूड ऑयल अगर आप उसमें डालोगे कार में तो कोई चलती नहीं है द कंबुशन जो एनर्जी कम्स थ्रू प्योरिफिकेशन तो आप जो जो प्योरिफाई करते जाओगे दीज आर ऑल एनालॉजी बट द एनालॉजी गिव्स यू कंसेप्ट बिकॉज यू कैन सी ऑल दीज थिंग्स यू कैन ओनली फील यू कैन ओनली हैव फेथ और बिलीव सो दैट्स व्हाई दे आर ऑल एक्सियम्स कि आप अगर कार्मिक मैटर में बिलीव करते हैं तो वो स्टेज फर्स्ट है अगर आप सोल में बिलीव करते हैं तो स्टेज फर्स्ट है क्योंकि बहुत से लोग सब रिलीजन दे डोंट बिलीव इन सोल यू नो सो देयर आर दीस असम्पशंस और एक्सियम्स सो दिस इज अ टेक्निकल टर्म ओके नेक्स्ट वन सो दिस इज अ डिपिक्शन ऑफ कार्मिक मैकेनिज्म ये साइंस है ये कार्मन्स है जो 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 मैग्नेट्स समझते हैं कार्मिक फोर्स लाइंस है ये कार्मिक मैटर है ये सोल है कैसे कैसे फॉर्म होता है एंड यू विल फाइंड इन माय नॉट दैट आई वांट टू गेट डीपर इनटू माय बुक बट यू विल फाइंड दिस काइंड ऑफ डायग्राम टू जो आपने क्वेश्चन पूछा ना ये दीज आर फोर्स लाइन ये कैसे बढ़ जाती है घट जाती है एंड हाउ दे इंटरैक्ट विद व्हाट यू डू नेक्स्ट सो दिस इज वन ऑफ द फेमस साइंटिस्ट कॉल्ड रोजर पेनरोज ही इज आल्सो इन ऑक्सफोर्ड And he knows about Jainism, but when I talk to him about karma, he believes in what is called quantum soul, and I told him that Jain believes in what is called karmic soul. So there is a very similarity, although I couldn't convince him because physics they want proof. You know, it has to go through the sun. Ask the local suns, you know, where they find the new particles. You know, that's where. So it is a challenge to Jains how to. Try to isolate karmons if they really are there. The hierarchy of life, I think there is no time for it, I think we will go through. But there is quite a lot, those who are seeker and those who have got, you know, trained mind, jo purana tha, I shouldn't use this, old wine into new bottle. I think we are all Jain, we are non-alcoholic. But that tells you कि जो पुरानी जो चीजें हैं पुरानी अपने जो पुराने शब्द हैं जो पुराने बोलने का है जो कि it can be all translated one to one in a more clear understanding. You Ekendriya, Vendriya, we all the time say, but you can connect it with life unit, or so, which is what I skipped. Anyway, आगे चलिए जल्दी जल्दी चलते हैं. The one key thing is karmic fusion in practice and destructive. So ये जो four है karmic fusion in JITO, perverted means non-restraint, carelessness, passion and activity. तो ये है जो मिथ्या दर्शन अविद्धि प्रमाद प्रसार योग बंधित्व. It is a translation one to one of Uma Swadhi's. पर ये passions और प्रसाया destructive emotion. And आपको मालूम ही है कि ये क्या चार हैं. I won't go into detail. इन्हें तो लोग मान माया. But these are the key things, and what you are missing is what Chitra Bhanu did, acronym AJAY. How you remember them is A for anger, G for greed, E for ego, D for deceit. So how you get the mark of time is, okay, next one. So this is the part of the videos, the representations of these four animals, which you know how in Jain the four Pashayas are represented. Next one. So we will leave it in question answer. So this is the new principle which I, my new book is coming, what I am working for last for 1919. It's almost finished. Four principles of Pashaya doctrine. So Pashaya Pahavad is a, one of the famous for Digambar. आप लोगों ने कशाय पहाड़ तो सुना होगा शायद. कशाय पहाड़ जो उनका शास्त्र है, बहुत बड़ा इम्पोर्टेंट शास्त्र है. बट दिस इज इन द मॉडर्न फोर प्रिंसिपल ऑफ कशाय डॉक्ट्रिन, एंड दे आर टेकन फ्रॉम दिस पार्ट. अगेन वी विल डिस्कस ऑल दिस इन व्हेन यू वांट टू. डू यू वांट टू आस्क क्वेश्चन जस्ट नाउ, और यू वांट टू गो अहेड फर्दर? What our forefathers and our thinkers did. Next one. So this is the very most important one. जो अपन सब जानते हैं कि हिंसा बहुत बड़ी चीज है. You know, for us. And this, can anyone read this?
Truth for me, violence to oneself and others results in the formation of the heaviest new karmic matter, whereas helping others towards moksha with positive non-violence results into the lightest new karmic matter.
So the concept is, if you see that number one, it is more to do with karmic matter, that how much you lose or how much you gain. It is just like in exams, you know, good marks you get or less marks you get depend on your activities. Same way, how much you absorb. So ye Mahavir Swami ka, we know all this well known. But this was done by one of our my helper in Englishman. So we thought of this, that what Mahavir Swami is seeing in, as you know, in this story, and this representation, that he is not looking at cobra, but he is looking at how he got this level of anger. So he is looking at, because of his power, he could see it. So the concept of Mahavira and compassion is more related to that, because he had less or very minimal form of new karmic matter, he could see through all this. So this is one of a representation. Next one. So you will heard, you might have known, this is one of the last one, parable of True Jain Personality and Ecological. So आपने लिशिया तो आपने सुना ही होगा बहुत से लोगों ने. It is quite a common theme for Jains. Sixth type, the next one. So this is a well-known parable that Jain is the best out of them, because he just picks the fruit what is on the ground rather than doing damage to the tree. In short, you know, this is the fast track. अपने कितने लोगों ने ऐसा पिक्चर देखा है? तो ये this is very James were very good. Not only they were genius as scholars, but to compete with other religion or to make them understand what James is thinking, they came out with many parables. Parables which gives some form of moral at the end. Okay, next. So this is the modern representation, and this is in my one of the videos, that these colors or aura are related to Lesha in some form or other. So what you saw on the tree, and this is the Jain who is sitting, who is compassionate. So they are different type. Okay, next one. So this is the teaching, what number that you are increasing or decreasing karmic matter, so you read out all this, and the last part which is important, the emphasis lies in reducing to a minimum number of intake of karmas in order to survive. If you need kuch khao to aap bahut badhiya hain, you know, the best if you could keep on doing fasting, but not, you know, from man vachan aur kaya se, you know, then this is, and then the result is eventually it is the less karmic matter. I think that's the connection between karmic matter or karmons. So this minimum number of intake, so you have to eat some things, but the less you take, so there is quite a deep work in it, including eating plants as food and causing loss of life, but how to have a balance. Chalo aage chaliye. So this is another parable, which is one very important one, Adhikantvad principle of Jains, multifaceted aspect of truth. So aap kitne logon ne ye dekhi aisi picture, six blind men and eight men, bahut baat hai. But the important point is that this is a part of a logic called Anekant, and it is goes hand to hand with Syarvad, which so there are two important principles, and they fit in with the current logical thinking of non-absolutism. So jo aapne matlab holistic truth or non-absolutism, ye uska part hai. It's a much broader than just elephant. And another challenge to all of you, jo aapne dekha, if you can find a source where it appeared, apne sir maharaj, hum bhi, tum bhi, they keep on quoting, but no one knows when George Bernard Shaw really said it, and where was it printed. So I asked many maharaj, many scholars, and from Western point of view, it is very important that you have to really give the source. And the best, I found something, but not yet enough to authenticate what he really said. Usne kaha ki apne thoda bahut dal diya isme. So this is another point of research. So you go at 6 minutes, I think. Go back, we just at about 3 minutes, roughly 3 minutes. I think that's important for the audience. Only 3 minutes later.
Depiction.
young generation, those who don't know Hindi or it's a system. That's the truth for the original, which is the important of the Hinsaka, four walls and all that. But it is a modern. Now this is the one of you, I don't know how many of you Ravindra Jain. So Ravindra Jain was a blind man, genius, a power. So we collaborated, I won't go through the whole story, I think it will take all of the time. And he was genius in the sense, he first learned from me what I wanted in the song. Then we had a lot of singing. But he was a poet, you know, lyricist, poet, singer, and music composer, so all in one. And he has done such a marvelous job. It is only not reaching to the right people, and thanks to the people like Viral and Rajasri, those are the two from Ahmedabad, and only I came to know through IIM when I come here quite often, that they think there is something in it and it should be promoted. So unfortunately my 80% of time goes in statistics, and as Viral knows, 20%, well, when I come to India it goes in reverse order. The most of time goes into asking right people and promoting Jain ideas. And so I'm going to meet Anna Hazare, and I'm going to, as I did with Abdul Kalam, to give some thought of the modern Jain thinking, that it is not actually individualized, but it is more universal truth in it. And kashayas are really very important, and how to conquer kashayas, I think. So usme jo niyam hai, kashaya mukti, kill mukti reva, this is one of the very famous Sanskrit, that if you get liberated from kashayas, then you get liberated, you have a total liberation. The only way is getting, but if we know management of anger, management of, the film banti hai, uske kitne classes chalti hai, kitne coaching, life coach, they talk about management of anger, so those are very important, and Jains have done a lot of research on it, psychological, breakthroughs they have, but it is all hidden. Because both Purani language, unless one doesn't translate into the current thinking, it is all obscure, obsolete. And uski fir value hai jo log hai ki arre Jain kya, Jain honne se kya fayda, kya milta hai mujhe, kuch milta nahi hai. But there is a more to it than milta, so to say. Anyway.
Like last line jo hai,
haan ji,
apraad akshar mein hai mitro apne ko aap satana.
It is an unforgivable crime, my friends, to torture oneself. Ye bilkul correct
concept means koi other ko satana
nahi hai, pehle to khud ko satana. The first apna jail ke andar important is first self.
Satana matlab kis tarah se,
satana matlab dekho wo kaise, you have desire, you know.